In this lesson, we'll use the periodic table to determine metallic character of various elements. And metallic character is defined as the tendency of an element to lose its outer electrons and become a cation. We've learned from past lessons that those that are more likely to become cations are those that are more metallic. And with that being said, the question reads, on the basis of periodic trends, choose the more metallic element from each pair if possible. Starting with question A, we'll compare tin and tellurium. Tin is more metallic than tellurium because as you trace the path between tin and tellurium on the periodic table, you move to the right within the same period. In fact, tellurium is to the right of tin, so we can predict that tin is more metallic of the two. Remember, metallic character decreases as you move to the right. Next, we will compare phosphorus and antimony. Antimony is more metallic than phosphorus because as you trace the path between phosphorus and antimony on the periodic table, you move down the column, and metallic character increases as you go down a column. So phosphorus wins that battle. Moving on to C. This time we're comparing germanium and indium. Indium is more metallic than germanium because as you trace the path between germanium and indium on the periodic table as shown, you move down the column. And metallic character increases as you move down and also to the left. So this acts as a synergistic effect, and we can tell right away that indium is the more metallic one of the two. In question D, we have to compare sulfur and bromine. Based on periodic trends alone, you can't tell which is more metallic because bromine's to the right of sulfur, and it's also one row down. It moves down a column. These effects tend to oppose each other, and it's impossible to tell based on periodic trends alone which one is more metallic. Next, let's compare germanium and tin. Germanium is right here, and tin is right underneath. Tin is lower than germanium in that column, so tin is more metallic. Gallium versus tin. Gallium is right here, tin is right there. We have an effect where it moves to the right and down a column, therefore we don't know. This is ambiguous. Phosphorus and bismuth. Phosphorus is right here, and bismuth is three rows down the column. So bismuth is the more metallic of the two. And lastly, for question one, H, we're comparing B with N, boron versus nitrogen. Boron is to the left of nitrogen, so it is more metallic. In question number two, they ask, arrange the following elements in order of increasing metallic character. So from least metallic to the most metallic. Let's start by identifying where these are. Silicone is found right here. Chlorine is right here. While sodium and rubidium are found to the left of the periodic table. The least metallic of these is chlorine, then silicone, then sodium, and finally rubidium. Because I am looking at this trend going down to the left being the most metallic. And there you have it. That is how to determine metallic character based on periodic trends alone.